Hello, my name is Roman Vlasov and I want to talk about benchmarking of machine learning hardware. Machine learning universe has very different tasks: image classification, text and signal processing, reinforcement learning, recommendations and so on. At the same time, all of them can be implemented on various platforms: CPU, GPU, distributed cloud solutions, FPGA, ASICs, you name it. Between high-level tasks and low-level platforms, we have different number representations like floating point and integers, different frameworks like TensorFlow, PyTorch, and more and more. All components of this system affect accuracy, computational time, and other parameters of machine learning system, which is stochastic. So, the problem is that the performance evaluation of hardware for machine learning tasks is rather complex and can be efficiently estimated only by teraflops. We should also keep in mind accuracy, latency, effects of parallel and distributed computing, training time, and so on. To solve this problem was built MLPerf benchmark, which is going to deal with it. MLPerf mission is to build fair and useful benchmarks for measuring training and inference performance for machine learning hardware, software, and services. MLPerf has a huge list of contributors, including Google, ARM, Cadence, Cisco, Facebook, HP, IBM, Intel, MediaTek, Microsoft, Nvidia, Synopsys, Baidu, Amazon, and so on. MLPerf consists of two parts: training and inference benchmarks. Probably, training benchmark is more interesting for research groups. The main idea of training benchmark of MLPerf is to measure time, power, and other parameters which we need to reach some desired score for particular models with a fixed dataset. Training benchmarking has a list of challenges. The first is computational optimizations. Used to improve computational speed and throughput, they can reduce final model quality, and the impact of it will be noticeable only on the final stage of learning, and we can't detect it at the beginning. The second is effect of scale. Building distributed or parallel systems not only improves training time by maximization system utilization, but affects learning algorithm. It became more stochastic, and we can need more iterations to achieve a baseline score. The third is run-to-run variation. Most ML models are initialized by random weights, and this leads to different final scores which will be achieved with some variations. So, to estimate the final score, we need to evaluate the system several times. The fourth is diverse software. In different frameworks like TensorFlow, PyTorch and others, some operations can be implemented in a mathematically different way. Also, the final score can be affect different processing orders, optimizations, and so on. For training benchmarking, we're taking such common tasks as image classification, object detection, instance segmentation, translation, recommendation, and reinforcement learning with corresponding models and fixed training rules. The main metric here is time to train performance. Quality thresholds are chosen near to state of the art. And there are two reasons. The first is preventing effects of lower precision optimization and scaling. The second is minimizing run-to-run variation, which decreases to end of training. MLPerf supports modifying hyperparameters to balance the need to tune for different systems with limiting the size of their hyperparameter search space to be fair to submitters with smaller computer resources. Now, let's talk about inference. Inference benchmark is more demanded for production tasks, and it has the following challenges. The first is diversity of models. It is difficult to choose the right models for benchmarking. Some tasks require high accuracy and low latency models. Another has strong power consumption requirements and a low, not so high accuracy and per meter offline processing. Covering the vast design space necessitates a careful selection of models that represents realistic scenarios. But even for a single ML task, such as image classification, numerous models present different trade-offs between accuracy and computational complexity, as shown on this figure. These models vary tremendously in compute and memory requirements. The second is deployment scenario diversity. In addition to accuracy and computational complexity, a representative ML benchmark must take into account the input data's availability and arrival pattern across a variety of application deployment scenarios. For example, in offline batch processing, such as photo categorization, all the data may be readily available in a local or network storage, allowing accelerators to reach and maintain peak performance. By contrast, translation, image tagging, and other tasks experience variable arrival patterns based on end-user traffic. Similarly, real-life applications such as augmented reality and autonomous ventures handle a constant flow of data rather than having it all in memory. Although the same model architecture could serve in each scenario, data batching and similar optimizations may be inapplicable, leading to drastically different performance. Timing down device inference latency alone fails to reflect the real-world requirements. The next is inference system diversity. The possible combinations of inference applications, data sets, models, machine learning frameworks, tool sets, libraries, systems, and platforms are numerous, further complicating systematic and reproducible benchmarking. This figure shows the wide breadth and depth of ML space. The hardware and software side both exhibit substantial complexity. MLPerf is going to consider these issues to build up a more fair, practically useful, and affordable test bench to estimate hardware platforms for various machine learning tasks. Here I just highlighted the main problems MLPerf struggles with. You can read more detailed information about it from official site, GitHub repository, and archive papers. Thank you for your attention.